I always marvel how cultural moments take root in a society. Sometimes they are just for fun, and other times they are managed in a way that makes them fun. For example, yesterday was May 4th, and it's become a day of fun to offer the Star Wars greeting, "May the 4th be with you." Today is Cinco de Mayo, a day of festivity often misunderstood as Mexico's Independence Day, which actually is in September, instead of a day Mexico won a battle against Napoleon III at Puebla, one of the only times Mexico overcame the many invasions of the colonialist. It was a battle grounded in the faithfulness of the people to protect their heritage. Today, as proclaimed last Sunday, we hear of the faithfulness of being a branch grafted to the vine of Christ, as an individual and as a church. One act of faithfulness is supporting the leadership of the church. Over the next few days, the first reading will record the proceedings of the Council of Jerusalem. This council addressed the issue of mandatory circumcision for the Gentiles as a requirement for becoming a Christian. The council, as with all councils, was guided by a faithfulness to the mission of Jesus. The report reminds us of our approach and acceptance of a council. Three things are important. First, a council convened by the Pope and with the bishops is more than just a nice time to discuss church issues. Decrees that come from a council are very serious. In a sense, a council is infallible in its teaching when it promulgates doctrines of faith and morality agreed to by the Pope and the bishops. Second, our faithfulness to a council is grounded not in one's opinion, but to the presence of the Holy Spirit, dynamically guiding the church and the work of the church. And third, despite discussion, disagreement, and different theological understandings, all church members are called to faithfulness in accepting the final decrees of the council as Spirit-filled and Christ-centered. Vatican II was the first council that centered not on what we believe, we were pretty clear on that, but on how we proclaim that belief effectively in a changing world. As a member of the church, we are all branches grafted to the vine of Christ, and our unity and growth depends on being faithful. For example, Dorothy Day often said that the goal of the Catholic worker was not success, but remaining faithful. A single, mature Christian positioned within a faithful community of disciples can inspire everyone to use their gifts to produce astonishing results. God alone can produce abundant fruit through us if we stay connected to the vine, even if we do not see progress on our own terms. God is the patient gardener who finds and nourishes such holiness. Pray that we remain open to the growth on the vine of God's love in Christ Jesus.